Hi, I'm Phil. I'm an application engineer here at United Electronic Industries, and I've designed this video as a brief tutorial on some of the unique features that would make your life easier if you're using the system for the first time. So what I'm going to do is launch PowerDNA Explorer, and this is a utility that will actually go out, scan the network for a rack or cube, allow you to click on the unit, and you can see the version of firmware. You can see the IP address of the unit. You can adjust the IP address of the unit. And you can also take a look at all the I/O boards present. If you'd like to exercise an I/O board, you simply click on one, go to this one, and I can start data acquisition. I have a loopback dongle attached, so you're gonna see alternating 7.5 minus 7.5 volts. Another feature is if you get a new release from us and you install it on your computer, you also have to update the firmware on the system. And you can do that pretty easily if you select Network, Update Firmware. You can point it to the new firmware, select Choose, and it will automatically update the firmware on the system. When the firmware and the library you're using are matched, you will no longer see a yellow warning sign here. Next, for diagnostics, we have what's called the hardware report. It's basically a hardware report of everything. So we're going to see the IP address of the unit, the version of software that's running on the PC, the version of our library you're using, type of system you have, the firmware version, and information about every single I/O board in the system. Status, type, logic level, this is the logic that's on the FPGA on each I/O board. And it's an incredibly helpful diagnostic tool. It gives us a snapshot of everything all at once. In addition to PowerDNA Explorer, if you'd like to access the system via the command line, you can bring up MTTY. The settings are set by default, 57600, none, 8, and 1. And when you connect to the system, you have a prompt. You can type help for a variety of commands. Some of the standard commands that are very helpful are show, which will give you every IP address in the system, ver, which will again show you the version of firmware that's running on the system, or if you need to change the IP address, you can type set IP and the IP address. For diagnostics, you have the option of having the serial terminal save all transactions to a file. So you'd log file to text, name it, and at this point, any transactions in the MTTY will be sent to that file automatically. The last utility I'd like to show you is DevTable. It produces a list of every I/O board in the system, its location, serial numbers, addresses. It's just a lot of information about what you have in front of you. So in general, these are the common things you might need to do. We might ask you for a hardware report. You may need to change the IP address of the system or exercise the system quickly in PowerDNA Explorer, and it's all right here for you. One point regarding the hardware, if you are going to remove an I/O board from the rack, we do suggest you power down the rack and take out the associated hardware. If you need to insert a different I/O board, please keep the rack powered off, and once it's in, power it back up. So we're available to help when you have questions, need tutorials. Please feel free to contact us by calling us or emailing support@ueidaq.com.